right, welcome back in Los Angeles at the LD Microcap Conference, and joining us is Bill Corbett. He's with DPW Holdings. Bill, great to talk to you. How you doing?
I'm very good, Steve. Nice to meet you.
So tell us a little bit about DPW Holdings. What's it all about?
So DPW is a diversified holding company. We've been trading for over 20 years on the New York Stock Exchange / American. Looking for disruptive technology around the world with a global impact, and increasing shareholder value through constantly monetizing those acquisitions in an effort to increase shareholder value.
What type of industries do you look at?
Well, we've been in the power supply business, both on the medical side and the military side, for over 30 years.
Okay.
We're looking for advanced technology that is disruptive, as I said.
Yeah.
We have a finance arm as well, which has a California finance lender, which is a division that I run.
Okay.
And we also have a hospitality division as well. So we're always searching to monetize those assets, spin them off if we see that as being the best path for our shareholders, and have a great network of people that are always constantly referring us to great management and good companies that we think are undervalued.
I looked at your recent revenue statements, and they were very positive. So obviously, what you're doing is working.
Well, yeah, we've had a lot of fun so far. We took control about 2 years ago. We're in an acquisition mode that really establishes great growth. So the top line's been growing exponentially. We probably do somewhere between, we've publicly stated, 60 million top line next year. Asset base has grown to about $50 million. So we've got our head down. We're working hard to try and increase value.
Are you adding money all the time? Are you trying to raise money all the time, or how does it work?
Yeah, we have an existing ATM in the market. We have a line that we've used periodically the last year. We have some great institutions that have helped us in that regard. We feel that in this environment that it's a great opportunity, because our stock trades an awful lot of volume, to basically bring companies under the umbrella of a diversified holding company. And that model so far has proven to increase revenue and asset base, which is really good for us.
Is it difficult to find the companies? You mentioned that you have people recommend companies to you, but do you have to really dig down deep and see exactly what that one little nugget to say, that's what we're looking for in a company?
Yeah, it's a great question. I mean, we have an extensive network, with two of us having over 30 years experience on Wall Street, and those relationships that were established over the years have really helped us in looking at companies. The key is really trying to find the ones that differentiate, that have some compelling aspect on a global imprint. For example, we have a sister company called AVLP that has a disruptive technology and technology that we think is a unicorn. It's an industry that's the second largest polluter in the world, being the textiles behind oil. This phenomenal technology has the ability to really not use water or power in making a product, for example, fabric, waterproof or fire retardant. It's been endorsed by Greenpeace. It's a company that we control about 83% of that enterprise. And so we, with a backlog that we have in that, as well as the backlog on the military side, we think the future looks very bright for us and our shareholders.
Well, let's talk about the future. There's some expansion plans in the works. So tell us what's happening as we head towards the end of 2018 and into 2019.
Yeah, so I mean, the military side, for example, we've been in the business over 30 years on the power supply, as well as the medical side of that business. The backlog is well in excess of $20 million in that. So we've made some acquisitions. We bought a company called Intertech in Israel. We have another military side. It's been in business, Gresham in the UK, for over 35 years. So, you know, we feel that the military business is very tough to get into. Mm-hmm. The backlog on that side is enormous. We think the opportunities are great. We differentiate ourselves because we've been in the business a long time. So next year we're hoping somewhere between, say, 55 to 60 million top line. We think we can raise that to possibly a lot higher in 2020. But the main thing for us is focus on cash flow positive, which we think we can be in the third quarter next year.
Right.
And as you bring in these assets, we think that the shareholders will be happy at the end of the day.
Well, it's a very interesting business. Thanks for sharing some time with us.
Appreciate it.
All right. So Bill Corbett, he's with DPW Holdings here in Los Angeles at the LD Microcap Conference.